Welcome back, everyone, to the Xamarin Show. I'm your host, James Montemagno, and today, my very good friend Brandon is returning to talk about...
That's right, James. Today, we're talking about Xamarin and Blob Storage.
Yeah, see how I set that up? I didn't even know what we were talking about. We're talking about Blob Storage. Now, last time you came on, we talked about using Cosmos DB for a really scalable data solution for mobile applications. Now, that's really kind of structured data, but Blob Storage, to me, is like unstructured data. Is that kind of how you would
totally
put it together?
Yeah, the way I like to think about it is, imagine just a folder on your desktop filled with a bunch of photos.
Yeah.
Those photos you wouldn't necessarily want to jam into a database because they're totally different sizes.
Yeah.
Who knows? So let's put them in a folder. And in this case, Blob Storage is that folder in the cloud.
Got it. And I'm imagining then the unique part is that I can then access that from my
Anywhere.
Mobile device?
Or oh, yeah.
Does it give me, what does it give me? If I upload a blob, let's say, I'm assuming it could be a photo, like you said, or a text file or something, like, what does it give me? Is it just magically up there? And then how do I get it?
Yeah, that's a good question. So actually, I'll tell you what, let's take a look at this,
okay,
this sample right here. So again, very simple app. It's just got a couple photos that we've been taking throughout the day.
Lots of James photos I see you apparently.
Yeah, James 1, 2, and 3.
That's good. I like that.
So yeah, I mean, we can tap on any of these photos. There's a good-looking guy right there.
Jamesception, I saw that.
That's right. So tell you what, let's take a photo for the Xamarin Show today.
A little monkey, maybe?
We'll do it live. Xamarin Show. All right, let's get the monkey in here. Cool. So when we click save, what's going on in the background is it's uploading to Blob Storage. It's putting
okay
that photo in that, think of that folder in the cloud, right?
Yep.
And I'm also taking a step further. I'm saving all the metadata from the photo actually in a structured SQL database.
Okay, so there's kind of a combination, because I'm so used to structured data where it's just, I have a list of monkeys, right? And this monkey is monkey one, monkey two, it's a baboon, it's a capuchin, it's a tamarin. I mean, you could just name monkeys
yep
all day. So when I upload it to Blob Storage, why do I need a structured part? What is that keeping then?
Yeah, that's a good question. So all that metadata from the photo, so in this case, I'm including the title.
Okay.
When we have anything in Blob Storage, we have a URL associated with it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm keeping that URL in the table.
Ah, okay. So once I upload it, Azure assigns a URL.
That's right.
So once I have that URL, is that how you're displaying these photos?
Yeah, exactly.
Got it.
So when this app loads, it's syncing its local database with that remote database has the metadata.
Mm.
And it's just assigning the image source to that URL.
Got it. That makes sense. Cool.
Couldn't be easier.
So once we have it up there, where is it at? Can I see it?
Like, yeah, let's check it out.
How did you set this up?
So I actually have the Azure portal up here. And what we're looking at here is our Blob Storage. So
what's a container? What is this container? Blob service container.
Good question. So containers basically our folder.
Oh, okay. Got it.
And containers, so this one, I have a container called photos. I could have another container called Word documents, PDFs, whatever. It's just kind of a way to keep organized like we would on our computer's desktop. And so yeah, if I click refresh here, we should see Xamarin Show pop up.
Oh,
there it is.
Got it.
And along with that, in this other tab, this is our SQL database with our metadata.
Okay.
And so if I run this query again, we'll see Xamarin Show right there with the URL.
Got it. So that container is like a folder on my desktop. I have all of my files in it. Is it all human, like readable, writable? Like, what's the authentication model for that then?
Yeah, you can choose how you want to do it. So we can have authentication at the container level.
Mm.
We could have it at the blob level. So I could have only certain users see certain images.
Got it.
Or I could organize my users in containers or folders and have a James's photo container.
Got it.
And then you can access all of your photos.
So only James could put it up there. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Now, did you upload from the mobile device directly into this container? How did that work?
Good question.
Yeah.
So you could.
Okay.
And there's actually an SDK that Blob Storage offers. So we can add that NuGet package to our app. But what I did here, since there's two steps, and we don't want to miss both of them, because I'm pushing that photo to Blob Storage, but I'm also adding that metadata to our database.
Yes, yeah, yeah. So, because I see, because So in my situation, if I was to do it directly to the APIs, you're saying I would upload the blob, I'd wait for that to return, but then I would have to then insert it into my Azure database and hope that all of that is successful. But you're not doing that.
Correct. Because my concern is always with mobile, we don't know what the connection is. Mm. So if I'm driving through a tunnel, maybe the photo gets uploaded to Blob Storage, but then I'm in a tunnel, I can't connect, and the metadata never goes to the database. Yeah. And so now we've kind of had this orphaned photo that is in the cloud, but I have none of the associated metadata.
Okay.
So what we're doing is we're actually uploading it to an Azure function.
Ah, our good old Azure function friends. Yes, I love
it. Yeah. So in the function, I send the photo from the app to the function. Function is actually what adds it to Blob Storage.
Got it.
If that's successful, it'll add it to our metadata database.
Yep.
And then when that's successful, it lets the mobile device know.
Oh, cool.
So if we miss a step somewhere along the way, no corruption, no worries.
Yeah, and in that instance, then as long as the mobile app then only cares that the blob got up there, it doesn't actually care that it finished or not, because it'll go query the database later. So if I'm driving along, I get the photo up there, and then immediately I'm in airplane mode, the Azure function is going to take care of the rest.
It's all happening in the cloud.
Are you able to take a look at that code?
Sure. Yeah, let's pull up that function code. So in the solution here, we've got our, let's shrink this a little bit. Whoops.
We have a back end.
There we go.
Okay, got it.
So yeah, we've got our the code for our mobile app, code for our back end, and then some shared code that I put in this common folder here.
Okay.
So in our case, we're talking functions, and I've got two. So we have a get photos function. Again, that was just kind of a simple way of making an API.
Got it.
And the post blob function, this is where we're posting that photo.
Oh, this looks pretty straightforward. It looks, I mean, it looks really simplistic. You take in a photo, I assume like a byte array or stream or something like that.
Yep, exactly.
And then this is a few lines of code just to insert into a database, get some information. Is it the blob storage service? All right, interesting. Okay, I'm trying to understand, put my mind in the developer who wrote this. Okay, so image blob, got it. Photo, got it. Insert it. Walk me through it in real talk.
Totally. So just like you said, this photo blob model, if we check that guy out, it's a byte array, just like we expect. And so we have to deserialize that. So we get our byte array. Mm-hmm. And then I have this class here called my blob storage service.
Okay.
And just like we talked about a minute ago, we're using the Azure Storage SDK.
But in the function.
In the function.
Got it. Okay.
That's right. And so it makes it super easy. So this save photo method, all I have to do is pass in the title of that photo. Mm. And I say, upload byte array async.
Oh, very cool. Very simple.
And that's it.
Super simple.
Yep.
Yeah.
And so the next step in the function is once that's done, add all that metadata to our database.
The Azure database. Got it. Okay. Okay.
And then we're good to go. And then it says, hey, I'm all done. It lets the phone know, save completed.
Ah. Now, what is the data structure of the photo that's being returned? Because you said that it's more than the byte array, right? Or it's not even the byte array, correct?
That's a good question. So we have two models here. One's our photo blob model, which we just looked at. That's just a byte array. And then the photo model looks a little crazy because I'm doing some stuff with some databases. But at the heart of it, it's just this URL and this title.
Oh, okay, got
it. So because it's in SQL, we got to know the updated at timestamp, the is deleted, all the stuff we know and love.
Got it.
But yeah, just URL and title.
Oh, that's easy peasy then.
Totally.
Cool, nice.
Yep, so when it's all done, I just assign that URL to the image source in this Xamarin Forms app, and we're good to go.
And you're good to go. That's it. So now, what does it look like from the mobile app side of it? Because this is the function side. We're inside of Visual Studio for Mac. You deploy that up there. How is the mobile app talking to this?
Yeah, good question. So this post blob function, let's see. So add photo, and right here. So I have an API service.
Okay.
And I say post photo blob. So let's check that out. And all this is doing is sending in, this is the URL for our function.
Yep.
It's passing in the title, so we can save that metadata. I've got a function key, and the functions just handle the rest. And so once it's done, it sends back that response.
Oh, okay.
And so it lets me know, is everything good? Is everything okay? And I even include in the response the updated metadata.
Oh, got it. Yeah.
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 So when it comes back and says it's okay, I also save that new metadata to the local database.
So we don't have to go immediately pull down the data. It's just there because it's literally waiting for it to return. And you'll know if everything was successful or not.
Totally.
Or you don't even have to. You could probably do something like fire it off. Say you're uploading in the back, like Snapchat style, right?
Totally.
You
fire and forget.
Yeah, fire and forget.
Yep.
But you have the photo there, and you know it's queued up.
Yeah, it just saves a step. Because, we can do fire and forget, but then we need the user to do a pull to refresh.
Yeah.
Sometimes they're going to get confused and wonder, hey, where's that photo I just took? So if we can save it locally first and have it there waiting for them.
And this seems also like a nice approach because for me, when I talk about databases themselves, and we're talking about Cosmos DB and we talked about SQL Server and things like that, the nice thing that you're talking to Cosmos DB is you're kind of talking to this query layer on top of it, right?
Right.
Where a lot of people are like, oh, I have a SQL database and I need to connect to the database. Like, from the mobile app, you don't really want to connect to the blob storage because that almost seems like a security flaw, right? Where this is built on top of Azure Functions, which is top on app service, so you can actually get all that security up to you to put in place.
Exactly.
That's cool. Because that's the number one question I always get is, hey, James, you've seen structured data 1,000 times. What about photos? My app needs photos.
All apps.
So, basically, all apps need some photos at some time to put in it.
That's right. And one of the big problems with photos is they're big. And so, sure, we could add these photos in, then upload it to the store, but maybe our app becomes 100 megs, 100, 200.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to download an app that big. Yeah. So we can pull them from the cloud after the download has happened. Or in this case, we'll have that user to upload photos too. So make it dynamic, make it interactive.
So are you just using standard HTTP requests basically then to send it up there and then you post it?
HTTP client, post to the cloud.
Nice. So that way it's fully cross-platform. So it's going to work on your iOS device, Android device, everywhere.
You got it.
Any .NET.
Any .NET
device.
Right.
Very cool. Anything else that you want to dive through on the actual storage stuff?
I think we hit on everything.
Nice. I love it. It's really straight and to the point because, again, like I said, I guess the number one question I get sometimes, which is I get the structured part. I don't get the blob part.
Right.
So, and all that is up in Azure. I'm assuming it's probably really cheap. Is it cheap?
Oh, yeah. We're using serverless functions. We're using blob storage. Right. Couldn't be cheaper.
Awesome. Cool. How did you create a blob before we go? Just so everyone kind of knows. You just go in. Is it like a blob thing in Azure? Or how does that work?
Oh, create new blob storage?
Yeah.
So, but we can come in here. I've got my blobs here.
Got it. So you were inside of this blob thing. That's the browse button.
Yeah.
When I hit new resource, how do you add a new blob? Is it blob? In a world where James thinks it's blob, could it be blob? Storage account.
Let's give it a second to pop up. There it is.
Storage account.
Yep.
Got it.
Didn't want to give away the big reveal.
Got it.
But yeah, that's a good point because in Azure, yes, there's blob storage, and that's what we're talking about today. But there's also table storage. You can have queues that help. Those are really helpful with functions. Maybe we'll do another episode on that.
Yeah.
But they all fall under the storage account on Azure.
Okay, got it. Perfect. So head over there. We'll put links in the show notes below, not only to the sample, which is super awesome because it's nice and straight and to the point, but also how to get your own storage account in Azure. Well, Brandon, thank you so much for coming on and crushing some code.
Thanks, James.
Yeah, absolutely. So until next time, this has been another episode of The Xamarin Show. Don't forget to subscribe. It's up over there, down over there. Ding that bell. You know what to do. That's right. Just point all over the page. Who knows where it's at? That way you get the latest Xamarin shows right in your inbox and in your feed. So until next time, I'm James Montemagno, and thanks for watching.